are the Expedition 36 crew, and you're watching Inside the Space Station. Do it!
What guy doesn't like playing with fire?
Hi, I'm Mike Massimino, and we're inside the Mission Control Center. And in just a minute, we're going to talk to three of my friends who are in space, Luca Parmitano, Karen Nyberg, and Chris Cassidy. You're watching Inside the International Space Station. All right, guys, we wanted to touch a little bit on the science that you guys are doing, and maybe we can start with Karen on that. What have you guys been doing science-wise, and what are you looking forward to accomplishing in that area, in the different science areas that you're working in?
So far, since we've been here, the major thing that Luke and I have been involved with is science on ourselves. We've been on the special diet where we're looking at the ratio of animal proteins to potassium, see how it affects our bones. We've been doing a microbiome study to see how long-duration space flight can affect our immune system and our microbiome. We've been doing some ocular health studies, which is a lot of new studies that they're doing to look at our eye vision. After long-duration space flight, look at the problems that folks have been having. So that's most of the stuff we've been doing so far. I'm looking forward to starting on some of the other science as well. Chris has been mostly doing that. I'll let him talk about it a little bit. But gosh, there's a lot of stuff that we can get the opportunity to do. I can't wait to see what's in store for us.
And to follow up with that, Mike, I made a comment in an event yesterday, what guy doesn't like playing with fire? And I've had the privilege for the last month to do an experiment called BASS, which we just took down yesterday, where there was different materials that we tested the combustion properties of inside a glove box. A really controlled, safe experiment, but it was fun nonetheless to see little balls of fire going on and take pictures of them in video. So that's been one that I've been involved in quite a bit. The other one I've done a lot has to do with moving fluids in zero gravity without the use of pumps, which is an interesting concept. Turns out you can change the shape of the container of the fluid and sort of drive where that fluid is going to go. The obvious application would be for fuel tanks and that sort of thing, so you get every last drop out of your fuel system. So really kind of exciting things. And then just like Karen said, being part of human experiments as well is kind of a fun thing that we don't typically get to do on Earth, and it's neat to do it, be a part of it up here.
Do you have a favorite run out of all of those that you're saying, well, this is really going to make a big difference for the folks on the ground, or that the principal investigator is really hot on? They're like, I know you can't really play favorites, but I mean, is there one that kind of stands out to you?
Hard to play favorites, just like you said, but one that I remember thinking, or still think, will have a lot of application on the ground is the use of ultrasound where MRIs would typically be used, and you can envision a small briefcase-sized ultrasound machine that's relatively inexpensive that can be deployed to all kind of areas of the world that people can get the healthcare that and diagnosis, proper diagnosis that they normally wouldn't get to have if they in areas that are less fortunate with medical care and that sort of thing. So I think that's pretty cool. It'll have a lot of application, a lot of benefit to many, many people around the world.
Hey, I think it's time for us to say goodbye to you guys. But it is great to see you. We really appreciate you spending the time with us. You all look wonderful, and I don't even have to tell you to enjoy the rest of it, because I know you are, and I look forward to seeing you back here in Houston. But thanks again for spending your free time with us.
Thanks, Mike. It was fun talking to you.
All right.
All right, man.
That was
thanks, buddy.
Good.
You think?
Yeah.
It was all right.
So-